Adrian with Moses. From that time on to now, we all that. Says, and though the Lord give you the bread of adversity and the water of affliction, because that's all we really have, you know, about like the GMOs, like the food that we eat nowadays is like full of GMOs, genetic modified organisms. I mean, that's the defiled food that we can eat as part of the curse. You know what I'm saying? We're dying, you know, trying to eat to live, but at the same time we're dying to live.
You're eating to die.
But it says, and though the Lord give you the bread of adversity and the water of affliction, yet shall not thy teachers be removed into a corner anymore. But thine eyes shall see thy teachers, and thine eyes shall hear a word behind thee saying, this is the way. Walk ye in it when you turn to the right hand or when you turn to the left. And that's what you saw with your eyes. You know, we're out here trying to teach our people.
I'm Christian. At the same time, like I said, I'm open-minded. I follow my ways. I believe it's a heaven and hell. I wouldn't say I'm going to heaven. But, I have the knowledge of it. I'm not.
Well, the reason why you don't come to go to heaven is why. But why can't you do it the way you want to? If you could, would you follow the rules? We all say yeah. But we can't do it. We call the spirit, which is the spirit. We can't do what it wants to do because this place allows you to go off and do what's not right. Now, that's what I'm trying to get at is that this place, America, was designed to make you not want to live the right way. To the point where you have to believe you're doing right when you're really not.
No. It's the only way you can find the right way. But you already said you ain't following his ways. So you're aware of that enough. But you just may not know all of them. But the thing that us brothers, when we come out to the highways and the byways, we rehearse the righteous acts. Rehearse means to practice. Because we ain't gonna get it right 100%, but that doesn't mean that we can go off and do what we think we can't get right. You know, like when I see he had that little, you know, that black and white, you know, that's something that Esau, the so-called white man, gave us here to kill us. Nicotine, what is it, like a serious cause of cancer. You see what I'm saying? I ain't trying to, you know, target you, but it's just something that there's certain things that we have the power to cut on. Yeah. But rehearse the righteous acts, because in the book of James, it tells you that we have to have faith and I believe in God.
That's why you can't argue with that atheist and shit. They don't understand faith.
Yeah, they don't understand it. I just want to let you know,
man, that for real, it's a real thing that these people on the side, man, were Israelites. Are you not? I mean, do you see yourself?
Because my mom's grandparents were they're Indians, but
one of these tribes, you know what I'm saying? But the whole point of it all is that these people right here are the true people of the Most High. And that's just the bottom line. You know, because there's a misconception in the earth that nobody knows the 12 tribes of Israel. I don't know if you ever heard of Jacob.
I think I might have.
You know, Abraham, right?
Yeah.
Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Well, Jacob had 12 sons.
And
he's up down right there. So in today's world, in our world today, people say, oh, we don't know who they are. But then you got people in Israel right now, the Jewish, saying that they are. But through our research and through what we believe through the scriptures, those people in Israel are not the true people. They're imposters. Because if you go through history, you read about the history about Israel, and when the Israelites were driven out, another people came in and dwelt in that land. See what I'm saying? So there's just certain things, man. You know? But this is our job, is to let them.
Egypt and Israel,
what was that?
There's a conflict between Egypt and Israel.
Yeah. Jesus, you know what tribe he came from? Or he came from the tribe of Judah. Okay? And Judah, they were Hebrew Israelites. So they spoke in Hebrew.
Yeah.
See what I'm saying? So his name, but if you want to say his name in English, it would actually be Joshua. Yeah, that's his real name. Like, in the Hebrew tongue, it's Yahweh Shah. That's how you call on the Most High Son for forgiveness and what have you. But, you know, like I said, wake up out of sleep, meaning that in your mind, because in our minds we believe in certain lies, and you still observe Christmas. You still observe Christmas. So yeah, you still like participate.
Yeah, I do. I mean, I don't like wake up and expect shit presents under the tree and shit. I gotta wear that like when I'm like 14.
Right.
But I guess like that pretty much. I mean, like, it's not Christian, so, but there's a lot of, that's the thing too, that, like, that's why I grew up in this place. Like, with me, I'm, like, there's a lot of conversations that I've heard, but, you know, I don't know, so I can't say shit, like, I don't know.
Yeah, I mean, that's what
happens. Honestly, I'm curious if it doesn't have me at third.
You're gonna go straight to the, get that one Ecclesiastes.